First match is going to be great. It's going to be fun. There's going to be lots of marks thrown, I'm sure. And the best bowler is going to win.
I think I'm going to face Tina in the finals.
Nervous, excited, all of the above. I mean, the ladder that we have is just amazing. The caliber of bowling is going to be really high, and I'm excited. Excited to get going.
It doesn't matter if it's TV taping day or not. It's just like any other time you walk into a competition. You shouldn't have any nerves. Maybe once in a while you might feel a little nervous, but for the most part, I don't. Not anymore.
That's my goal. I want to throw against those guys again and make it to the top.
Welcome everyone to Classic Candlepins. My name is Frank DeLuca. I, alongside Nick Zuffalato and for our entire crew, thanks for joining us. We are going to see a great match between Kristy Lipke, who edged out Joanne Rosano last week, Nick.
And it's a very, very good finish by Kristy.
Indeed it was, and she's facing off against Jessica Stockton, who threw a 589 qualifying score for the second seed.
She bowled very well in the qualifiers. Jessica is a very good female bowler, and once again, I can't stress it enough, we're expecting a great match, Frank.
Absolutely we are, and we'll be back with the start of our match after this timeout. All right, folks, welcome back to Classic Candlepins. My name is Frank DeLuca, and alongside Nick Zuffalato, we are going to get underway in our third round matchup, where Kristy Lipke will get us started on lane 7 against Jessica Stockton, as they show a bit of sportsmanship.
Good to see you brought me back for a third week.
Well, you know, your rate was cheap, so we pay you hourly. And
it's not too bad, you know.
At the rate of $0 an hour, so.
And a pizza lunch.
Yes. And coffee and lunch. And then there's a big ball by Kristy Lipke. Finds the 1-2 pocket. Use the triangle left. 4, 7, 8, 10.
Look at this, Frank.
And she's too heavy on the 4 pin. Good bid. Nick, we saw Kristy Lipke last week edge out Joanne Rosano by 11 pins in a very close match.
She had a very clutch finish. She had a single pin in the 10th. She stapled it. I believe she filled it with 7, correct?
I believe so, and that put her...
Put the pressure on Joanne.
Yes, indeed. Takes out just 3 on that first ball.
Christy's been bowling very well.
She has.
She's been revving it up when she needs to, and so it's been a great display of clutch bowling on Kristy Lipke's end.
She's from Bedford, New Hampshire. League average of a 114, high single 201, which is unbelievable.
It really
and
is.
And a high triple of 447. And she's got a 9 box. And we get our first look at Jessica Stockton. I misspoke in our opening segment, as I typically do. She, to qualify, threw a 583. I had said 589, but Jess is making her first television appearance. League average of 105, high single 181, and she's all over the headpin to begin with.
Yes. Jessica is a teammate of mine and a very good friend of mine, and I know she's capable of putting up very big numbers. She's a great, great competitor.
Leaves the 3-4.
Great 9 box.
She starts with the 9 box. Jessica's high triple is a 413. She does her bowling out of Lynn, Mass. And Peabody, Mass. And she catches a break off the 4 and 7 pins, leaves just the 1-2.
Jessica's Worlds team, I believe it was this past year, 2 years ago, they finished second. I believe it was like a 2 or 3 way tie.
Yeah,
but nonetheless,
she had noted on her bio sheet. And she starts with the spare.
Start.
that she was the runner-up in the team, the women's team event this past year. I believe that tournament this year is taking place up in Augusta, Maine.
Yes.
And Kristy Lipke. Big head pin hit leaves the 5-7. The old Woolworth split.
The what?
Woolworth. How old are you, Nick? Have you never heard that?
I don't hear these terms.
Oh! Makes a great bit at it. Unless I'm totally incorrect, but I believe the 5-7 or the 5-10 is affectionately known as the Woolworth split. Courtesy of Don Gillis.
Could be right. I'm not exactly well rounded in my bowling leave terminology.
That's why we have you here. Kristy has two consecutive 9 boxes, looking for her first mark, and she's through the middle. Do you know the name of this one, Nick?
I think something, a spread hawk or something.
We're all too familiar with the spread eagle.
How does that happen?
And she leaves 4 standing.
So, Frank, the winner of this match is going to move on to face our number one seed, Tina Ward.
Yes, Tina Ward threw a 600 in the qualifying round, or roll-offs, rather.
I think it was 608. Jessica's going to step back up, and she's on a spare fill right now.
She also won our ladder last year, the women's ladder last year.
Yes.
Made an appearance in the Tournament of Champions and actually beat Brian Fournier in the first match.
Yes, that's correct.
Jess... deliver her bonus ball. Heavy on the 1-2. She has an 8 fill.
It's a very tough leave, but it's still a very good fill nonetheless.
It's the 4-10.
Off the wall. Oh. A great 10 box by Jessica. That's ideally what you want to do on a shot like that. Make a bid at 1, try to send it.
Right.
If you leave the other one, just go get it. So that's it's a very good 10 box by Jessica. She's going to step up over on lane 6.
Four horseman right plus the 8 pin. Also known in the local candlepin world, to us at least, as the Kaleri.
Yes. Very difficult to leave, and we've mentioned it throughout the broadcast.
Right.
It just really is such a difficult shot to convert. And Jessica with a great bid.
She goes outside, takes out everything except the 6-8. And she'll shoot that for a 9.
That's still a great out of that.
She's at 46 through 4. 13-pin lead over Kristy Lipke. And she delivers.
That's great ball
by
Kristy.
It's going to go for a strike.
Just enough, Frank. Just enough.
Well, that's all it takes. Man, that was certainly a crowd pleaser here.
Frank, our crowd just continues to grow and grow with each broadcast.
It's great. It should. This is great competition. Kristy.
Kristy!
Right in the pocket. 1-2 pocket leaves the 4-5-7-10. And Nick, that looked like a great ball to me.
Frank, we've been seeing this a lot throughout all the matches in this ladder. It's... you hit the head pin, you get some weird leaves up there.
Right, and here's the second bonus ball. Fills it with an 8.
You know, Frank, that was the right idea. Just go for the fill. I mean, I didn't like that wood very much.
I agree. Eight fill, 8 box. She's going to be at 59 through 6. And that will have made up most of her deficit to Jess, or Jessica. As she lines up to deliver.
Great pitch. Just outside.
And she's going to take out that 7 pin. Makes it a little bit easier, Nick.
It does. It's one less pin to carry. She throws the right ball for this kind of leave anyway, so. Especially on this side. She... Oh, wow. Great try.
A little too heavy, and the four pin still remains, but... And that'll be nine box.
So far, Frank, through the first half, Jess has only left up two pins. Or, sorry, three pins. So it's been a pretty good display early on Jessica's pinning so far.
Right, and the TV lights don't seem to have much of an effect on her. I think she's thriving.
Her first ball, she hit the head pin.
And she's off the mark.
She's got a working pitch, though.
A bit of a break. She's got the head pin plus the triangle right. Got some wood up in the front there. I think, Frank,
I think you're just going to want to be as full on that head pin.
Right.
Try not to catch that cap because that's going to divert the ball away.
And she takes everything.
I was wrong.
What a shot.
I was wrong. Great shot.
So she's at 65 plus through the sixth box, and Kristy Lipke lines up and fires.
Kristy with a great pitch.
And another big hit. Leaves eight pins standing, the two and four. She's got a piece of wood up in front of the two that could act as a guide. And it didn't go. The four did not go. Box.
So that'll bring Kristy to 69 through 7. And Kristy has left up the 1, 3, 6, 7, 9, 10. Got a piece of wood in front of the 9 and the 10 pins, though. Let's see what she does with it.
Looks good.
Great try.
A little too full in that head pin, Nick.
Yeah.
And a nine box.
That'll bring back up Jessica Stockton, who is sitting at 65 through 6.
Plus this bonus ball.
Exactly. This could be a very big bonus ball. Could create some early separation. She joints out four.
She just got by the head pin on that one.
Frank, I'm splitting these, I think.
I think that's your best approach.
Well, with the way she throws her ball, too.
Little good bid. Four. Yeah, got everything except the left side, the 4-7.
Great 10 box out of that.
So Jessica certainly dialed it in, Nick. She's...
she's been pinning very well.
Very, very well.
And, I mean, she came right back from that four-fill, and she's, she grinded it out for a great 10 box, so... she looks very focused right now, Frank.
Indeed she does.
Definitely making the best of her first appearance on TV. Takes out the right triangle. Oh, Frank.
Oof. A bit unconventional, but she almost made that spare. The pin is still rolling. That wood is still rolling toward it, and it's not going to be enough.
Well, Frank, a little bit of luck on her side there. She took advantage of that and got the 10 box
right
to extend her lead to 11 pins.
11 pins, 89 through 8, and 78 for Kristy.
Kristy takes a deep breath, gets ready to roll. Look at this.
Look good going down. Oh. She's got a 6-7-10 split.
Frank, call me crazy, but I'm going on that right cap of that middle wood.
You're crazy.
Okay.
No, I think it's not a bad idea.
Oh!
And she thought so as well. It didn't go.
See, she and I were on the same page
right,
there.
Right.
So you can call her crazy at the end of this, too.
I'd never.
That pin will be no good.
That'll be an 8 box.
So that'll be 86 through 8.
Wow.
4, 5, 9, 10.
Frank, on this one, I think I'm going for that 2-pin or left to shoot it off the wall. Really don't know what else you can do with it.
That's unless she went to the other 2-pinner. Good bid.
She made a nice shot.
She'll be open in the 10th. 9 box put her at 95. Opposite Jess's 89 in the 8th.
So, Frank, Jess is going to want to pile on as many as she can here.
Right. A couple marks would put her in a good spot.
That's a great pitch, Frank.
And she gets the break, leaves just the 6-pin for a single.
Beautiful ball by Jessica. She is all
over. She picks it up.
Frank, no better time than that.
Right.
Facing an open box in the 9th. Let's see what Jessica can do with this.
Bonus.
There it is, Frank. Look at this.
A big hit.
Oh, that's going to swing, I think, just enough.
Fill of 8. Leaving the 3-6 with wood.
Oh,
and she's got it.
Just enough. Great shot by Jess.
Excellent shot. And she showed a little bit of body English there.
Very excited indeed, Frank. I've been bowling with Jessica for a long time. I haven't seen her this focused in quite a while.
Here's the bonus. Fill of 6. Gives her a 123 for a 28-pin lead through the first ring.
Not a bad TV debut, Frank.
Absolutely not. The lights have not affected her whatsoever. So we will be back with second string action. Get a shot at our screen scoreboard there. Kristy Lipke, 95. Jess Stockton, 123 for a 28-pin lead. We'll be back with second string action after this timeout.
I'm Kristy Lipke, and you're watching Classic Candlepins.
A 28-pin lead for Jessica Stockton as she throws a 123 over Christy's 95 string. Jess will get us started on lane 7 as she finished her last 2 boxes of the first ring with 2 marks. Nick, she is on fire.
Frank, she had 4 marks that game. She left up 3 pins. Yeah, only 3 pins that game.
Impressive bowling. Impressive.
It's a very impressive TV debut, nonetheless.
Speaking of TV, Nick, Jessica notes on her bio sheet that she's a WWE fanatic.
Yes. I personally, I'm not a wrestling fan, but when it comes to anything wrestling, she knows everything about it.
Sure. And
oh, what a great try. Great try. An 8 box to start up.
She's 31 years old. She's from Lynn, Mass. She's single. She's a delivery driver, I believe, for Amazon. Nick, is that correct?
Yes, yeah. Amazon, yep.
And she's also on the board of a theater company in Saugus.
Yes, I've been to a few of the plays, and they're very, very good.
just by the head pin, has the four horsemen left plus the 6-10.
I think the way that her ball goes, I might want to go to the outside of the head pin.
Yeah, our viewers will notice that she's left-handed, so she goes from left to right. And she's a little bit off her object there.
If I'm her, I'm just going to probably go for two, but I mean, it really depends on what she's thinking right now, obviously. Smart move.
She does that.
It's a very smart move. I feel like if she goes at the head pin, you're risking only plucking one of them out.
Right. Right.
Especially, I know she's up quite a few now, but if she takes Kristy Lipke lightly,
she's in trouble.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, Kristy's already won two matches in this ladder, so.
Kristy is on the head pin.
Wow.
But
Frank
really has
this?
Nothing to show for it. Yeah, I don't know.
It's been the story of this ladder so far, Frank.
Right. Diamond right plus the 4-7. Kristy is 39 years old. Mother of three children. She is a season ticket holder to the Patriots. New England Patriots. And she'll start with an 8-box, just like Jessica.
Now, Kristy's going to want to try to do something here to take advantage of that 7-box that Jessica just threw. Try to start to chip away at this lead that Jessica has pounded on early. And he won 3-7-9-10 with a double wood behind the, in front of the 9 and 10. Oh!
Just too heavy in the pocket. 7 pin still stands.
It was a great try.
It was a great bid, yeah.
$10. Now we'll get our second look at Jessica Stockton this game. See if she can bounce back from a slow start. And she's on the head pin.
3-6.
Great first ball. Not too fancy about it, Frank. Just go at it.
Probably want to split these or play them outside.
Either or.
Oh, wow.
It's a little too far outside for Jessica.
Tough 6 pin.
Great try nonetheless.
And a 9-box.
And just moves over to lane 6.
You can see in the background awaits spectates Joanne Rosano, who Kristy edged out by 11 pins last week. Just as off the head pin, leaves the four horsemen left plus the 6 pin.
She's got a piece of wood there too, Frank.
She does, yeah. I think she expected worse off that ball, Nick.
She's off it. She'll take a 9-box out of that.
So she's yet to mark, as has as the same situation with Kristy in this second string.
A little bit different of a start this game compared to last, but still a long way to go, Frank.
Absolutely. That looked good going
Kristy
down.
Kristy with a great pitch.
And that pin's going to come up and tuck right into the two.
Her body English is indicating she wanted that wood to come up and hit it hard.
And she lost
she
that one.
She off it.
And that's what she wanted in the last ball. Missed opportunity by Kristy, but 10-box nonetheless.
She still makes up a pin.
136.
Just a bit outside. So I'm gonna at least 10 this out. Pick up another pin. She will match Jessica's 9 box.
Lead of 24 for Jessica through 4 boxes in this second string.
Cuts Jessica's lead down to 24 after that trip up. So she only lost one more pin. It's off by a little bit. Frank, we've seen the shot made earlier in our ladder, I believe.
I believe we did.
So it's definitely doable.
Just gets through the hole.
Don't want to get a big out and get this half over with and go into the next one strong.
And that's the attitude you have to maintain throughout any kind of match.
Well, you know something, and I've received a lot of info. A lot of tips from. That's a tough 6 box for her. From a lot of the veteran candlepin bowlers that I've gotten to know over the years, and you know, they all say the same thing. Generally, you just gotta reset and forget it. Each box is, you know, it's a new box. It's you gotta just come back and forget it.
Right. Just delivers. She's off the head pin, takes out 7 pins. 1, 2, 8 still standing. Oh, just too heavy on that one.
A little too full on it.
Stubborn 2 pin.
Frank, she had the right idea on that one.
Right. So we are markless throughout this second string thus far. Jess is at 48 through 6. Kristy, 37 through 4.
Frank, do you think sometimes when you have to start a string off and you have to switch to go into second or vice versa, do you think sometimes that can throw you off a bit?
Perhaps, because you do throw those 4 consecutive boxes.
Yeah.
If you think about it, you're going from...
No, it's entirely true. I mean, sometimes it's just the little things, you know.
Right. And Kristy goes outside, makes a great shot.
Great shot by Kristy.
Textbook, Nick, textbook.
No better way to hit it than that, Frank. She's going to want to do as much damage as possible.
And considering she is opposite Jessica's 6 box, she has an opportunity to.
She's already chopped the lead down to 20.
Looks good.
Kristy with a great pitch.
And there's a big 9, Phil.
Goodness, what is holding that up?
I don't love that wood, Nick, but I'd probably go as high as possible. I could be wrong.
Yeah.
She goes low, and that's what I was afraid of.
Yeah, I think you were right, Frank. I mean, that... I think even if you go at the 10 pin, I don't think it was angled enough to carry it.
And that'll be a 10 box, so she's at 66 through 6. Cuts the lead down to just 10 pins, Nick.
Well, I mean, you see there, this is where pinning becomes so crucial.
Right, right.
I mean, it really can change the outcome of a game, plain and simple.
We've seen it time and again.
Right.
It's a profile shot of Jessica Stockton as she lines up. Look good going down, but that was just too heavy, and she gets through the middle. Takes out 4.
Well, she's going to want to play the 3 right to try and swing it over there.
I agree. That would be my approach as well.
She opts to go the other way. Maybe indeed to just try to pin it out for the 10, which is not a...
Not a bad option.
Yeah, it's a very good idea. Still a great nine box out of that. Those pins could come in handy later on in the match, Frank.
Oh, I think they will.
I mean, we continue to discuss the topic of pinning, and it really is so crucial in this game. So that was a great nine box by Jessica.
Jessica leaves the four horseman right plus the nine pin, basically taking out the entire right side or left side of the deck.
I almost like the sleeve better than the four horseman because of that back pin.
It's a little bit of reassurance. Mm.
She will,
and that's why.
Great shot by Jessica. No better time than then. See Kristy Lipke step back up.
A little bit of added pressure by Jessica. As Kristy delivers. Half was to right. So maybe that roadblock spare didn't hurt as much.
No.
Although yeah, I'm sure she'd go for the two extra pins.
Wow. Just been one of those days, Frank.
It has.
Oh, that's a tough six box. I will say, Frank, there's an overwhelming amount of support from the crowd for each.
There is. This is perhaps our biggest gallery thus far, and I think it's because you're here. Good break there for a strike.
A little bit of lady luck.
I can't really explain that one, but I think she hit the three pin first. I'm sure we'll get a look at that on replay. But right on time, just to start as filling a mark. She's filling her spare here. As she delivers the bonus ball.
And Jessica gets a little bit of a break.
Indeed, leaves the four horsemen left. Leaves the four pin.
It's a great bid.
And a nine box.
That brings her to 82 through 8. But could still get herself going with one here carried into the next game.
And Christy's already at 82 plus her strike fill, so.
Yes. She's going to want to chop into the lead as much as possible.
Here's Jessica Stockton.
She is on the head pin, Frank, and she looks at...
looked pretty good to me.
A very strange arrangement. Takes out the 1-2-4-8. But, Frank, she does have that piece of wood touching that 5
yeah,
pin to the
left.
Yeah,
I think that could actually...
It could spin over and help carry the 7 pin.
Right. She misfired there, so she'll be open in the 10th.
She's just going to want to get these three and get out of this game.
And she does that.
Great 10 bucks.
92 for the second string. And Kristy Lipke is filling a strike in the 8th box. Double goes a long way, Nick. And look at that.
The double, not the double you were referring to, but
it's the 3-7 double. And looks good. She'll pick it up.
Great shot. Frank, this is very timely.
Right, this is clutch bowling, as we saw from Kristy last week as well.
Yes.
She is filling this spare. She's at 102 plus this fill.
And Frank, one important thing to look at is she's she got to work and pitch on that one. She's only left up a few pins this game.
Right, which is essential.
It is. I mean, she's only left up, I believe, 7 pins, which is really not too bad.
And she, look at that 10 pin.
Oh, my goodness.
And she's talking to it. She's wondering how that did not fall, just like the rest of us in the gallery. No luck there, Nick.
That's really what it just comes down to, that there is no luck.
And that'll be a 9 box. So through 2, Kristy Lipke cuts Jessica Stockton's lead down to 3 pins with a big 117 to Jess's 92.
It's just got interesting, Frank.
Absolutely. This is what we're all here for. So
exactly.
Take a look at our scoreboard there. 215 two-string total for Jessica Stockton to Christie's 212. We'll be back with the exciting conclusion in third string of this third-round matchup of our third ladder of the season of Classic Candlepins after this timeout.
I'm Jessica Stockton, and you're watching Classic Candlepins.
Welcome back to the exciting concluding third string of this Classic Candlepins third round matchup of our third ladder series of season 2.0. We have Jessica Stockton at a two-string total of 215 and Kristy Lipke at 212. My name is Frank DeLuca, and I'm here with Nick Zuffolato.
Still here.
Nick, this is a great match going.
I mean, it really is. Kristy made up a lot of pins that second game.
And she's not stopping. Look at that. 4-5-7. Not a great lead, but...
it was a great ball, though.
It was. And as you were saying in our last string, our gallery continues to grow.
It's, I think this is the largest gallery I've seen, at least since the show has started airing.
And Kristy will have a 10 box to start out.
Which is always great. A lively crowd makes a match more interesting.
Oh, yeah, certainly.
Kristy. Once again, Frank, a beautiful first ball, but...
Yeah, and then she leaves the 3. 4-6-10.
She's got a piece of wood there, but I don't really know how much of a factor it's going to be.
Too heavy on 3. I think we mentioned earlier in the broadcast that Kristy is the winner of 3 Pro Tour events, 2 World Championship events. She's made an appearance on the old Comcast show. And she's the 2014 ICBA champion, singles champion.
I feel like she goes to that tournament quite often, the ICBA tournament.
Well, we've seen now for the third straight week her skill.
Right.
Certainly.
She's displayed it all. I mean, she's made some great shots. She showed how clutch she can be. And
right.
She's a very talented bowler by every right.
Jessica starts off with the 1-2-10.
Outside.
Looks good for a great shot. Great shot for a spare.
Excellent shot. That's exactly what I would have done if I had her ball. With that left to right motion,
right.
I think you have a better shot at going the way that she did.
Yeah, the ball taking the pin out rather than the wood.
Yeah, absolutely. So let's see what she does with this bonus ball here.
Here's the bonus. And that's her 6.
It's not too bad.
1-2-4-10.
This is almost a slight variation of the shot that she had
right.
just converted. So let's see
probably
if she can do it 2 times.
Yeah,
in a row
probably
now.
Wants to do the same thing. Almost.
Oh, very close.
Just gets by the head pin.
She had the same idea. She had the
right.
same idea. Want to just get as many pins as you can now. She does. Very good out.
That'll be a 9 box. Picks up a couple more pins over Kristy. Now has a 9 pin lead. still anybody's game, Nick.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, with 8 boxes to go, the whole game can change in 2 boxes, you know? Beautiful ball by Kristy.
Solid 4 pin standing. She's got a piece of wood. I think it's duck soup time.
Indeed it is, Frank. Indeed.
Yes.
Duck soup is served.
Nick, something interesting to note is that if Kristy wins this match, throughout all of our ladder series so far, season 1 and season 2, she will have traveled farthest up the ladder. She would have run the table.
Yeah, I never really noticed that.
And
wow.
Heavy through the middle, but picks up 6 nonetheless.
That's a very
decent.
Strange.
Yeah, decent fill, but a tough leave to look at.
Brings it a 35 through 3. She might have been thinking to play that outside to spin it off the wall and see what happened.
You never know. She'll have a 7 box there. Puts her at 42 through 4. And as I was saying before, Nick, oddly enough, the bowler to travel farthest in our ladder was our last lady's ladder. Was Deb Regan. She had made it as far as Kristy has and then lost to... I don't remember who, actually.
I'm trying to think of who it was,
Nikki McKeever. I'm sorry.
That's right.
And a big ball for Jessica.
Big ball by Jessica, yeah.
That piece of wood is going to have to be cleared unless it rolls into the gutter.
And
it looks like it's
going to
travel
legs.
Back. And it's going to get some legs. Yep. We'll take a look at this one, folks.
Maybe it'll turn, Frank. It might turn.
The wrong way. So she's looking at the 4-7 for a 2-pinner.
Yeah, she will get it.
She picks it up.
Very clutch right there. She's answering Christie's spare that she laid down in the third box.
She is 2 for the first 3, and she's going to rely heavily on this fill ball. Here's the bonus.
Jessica on the head pin.
Big ball.
What a great fill by Jessica. Bringing it to 44 through 4. Staring at the 3 pin. She will get it.
All over it. So Jessica certainly applying pressure to Kristy Lipke.
Frank, it's the Jessica we saw in the first game so
right.
far. She's really, I think she realized what she's got to do to put herself in a good position.
Here's Kristy.
Kristy comes back.
Diamond left.
It was a great ball by Kristy.
It was.
Just a little too late, I think. She will get
and
it.
She gets
yes.
the diamond.
A little celebratory pump by Kristy over there.
Nick, would you say that's one of the tougher shots in candlepin bowling
that
we see very commonly?
I think so, and I believe we discussed it earlier. I think maybe in the first match even. It seems like sometimes you punch through, you take the 2, or you leave one up, you know?
Right, right. Here's the bonus ball.
What a pitch.
Can't break up the split, but an 8 fill nonetheless.
Oh, maybe a 9. It might.
Almost.
Oh. Okay. Let's see what Kristy can do with this. Really no way around it. You got to pick a side of that 4 pin and give it a ride and get
right.
it moving. Oh. Great try. Great try.
She had the right idea. She got by it, though.
She's going to have to go for a 9 box. And she does.
69 through 6. Jessica Stockton is filling a mark. She's at 54 plus a ball.
Now Jessica's going to want to keep piling it on here.
Here's the bonus.
Oh, Frank, she gets a little help. Little help.
She gets
from
a strike.
Ends, baby. Much like Kristy earlier in this match, Jessica herself has also gotten a backdoor strike.
And that makes three in a row. And here's the first of her bonus balls.
Will be another working pitch.
Indeed it is. 1-8-10, still standing. Too heavy in number one.
Great try, great try.
She's got knee fill.
Bring it a 82 through 5.
And a 9 box puts her at 91. Increases her lead to 25 pins. So
Frank, she's put herself back in the driver's seat.
Right, Kristy has a lot of work to do at this point.
She definitely took advantage of that strike, the grade 8 fill down there, and Christy's going to have to do something here, Frank.
Four horsemen right plus the 7 pin.
She's still got the wood to help her carry the 7.
Just slides by the object there, leaves the 1-7. And a 9 box.
So, Frank, a mark here would be very, very crucial for Kristy.
Right.
But we've seen it in the previous game. She's capable of it. She comes
back.
That's
a big ball. And look at this once again. Just not really caring much in her favor.
Frank, this is just... it's just bad luck, I think.
Tough shot. It's a 4-8-10. She could play the 4 on the left side. And
look at this.
Almost. She had the right idea.
Great try.
Another 9 box. She's at 87 through 8. And she'll be in dire need of a mark at this point.
Yes.
Especially depending on what Jessica does in these two boxes here. Through boxes completed, lead of 25 for Jessica. And she will start her 7th box here.
Kaliri.
4 horsemen right plus the 8. No wood.
I think this is the side that her ball would have a little bit of an advantage on. Great try, great try. She's just got to keep pinning.
And she leaves all three standing for a 7 box. So a mark here would guarantee her a little bit of insurance.
It would absolutely apply a little bit more pressure to Kristy going up.
And it looks good. It's a big hammer. No doubt about that one.
That was a bomb, Frank. Looks like Jessica was a little eager to continue on.
Right. That was a bomb.
Frank, this is do or die right here.
Yeah, she's in a markout situation where she either needs to string together two or a double strike or something of that sort, and she doesn't necessarily throw the first ball she wanted to. And look at that. What a great bid. Still leaves the 6-10. And a 10 box.
We'll see what Kristy finishes up with here.
Winner of this match faces Tina Ward, who won our ladies' ladder last year. She threw a 600 in the qualifying roll-off. She's going to get by that, so. Most likely after Jessica's first ball, that'll seal the deal, and she'll finish with a 6 box. Kristy Lipke's 103 for a 3-string total of 115.
Jessica needs one pin. Well, yeah, she needs to just knock one down. No, two of them. I need to learn to do math, Frank. That'll do it.
Spread eagle, but that's the right place for it.
That's right. And the rest of this is just going through the motions.
Fill of six put her at 114 thus far. She's already taken the victory.
Mm-hmm. So like I said, at this point, it's just going through the motions.
And a great out for a 9 box.
So Frank, Jessica will move on to face off against our defending champion.
Yes.
Tina Ward.
From Western Massachusetts, or somewhere out there. I'm not entirely sure where she's from. But
yeah, I believe so.
We'll fill you in next week on that. But we both know, Nick, that she is deadly.
Tina Ward is arguably the top woman bowler in the game right now.
I would agree with that
and
theory.
I think a lot of other people would agree with that as
right,
well.
Right.
She's just so deadly and so good. But if Jessica brings this ball next week, she'll definitely give Tina a great run.
It'll be quite a match. And Jessica Stockton finishes with a monster 132 for a 3-string total of 347. And she is the victor over Kristy Lipke's 315.
That was a great finish by Jessica.
Quite a finish and excellent TV debut, Nick.
Absolutely.
And she'll be taking on Tina Ward next week. And we will be back to talk with Kristy Lipke here on Classic Candlepins after this timeout.
Hi, I'm Tina Ward, and you're watching Classic Candlepins.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Classic Candlepins. My name is Frank DeLuca alongside Nick Zoffolato. We are here with today's runner-up, Kristy Lipke. Kristy, 315 wasn't enough for Jess's 347. I felt like you bowled well. You were throwing a good ball, but you just couldn't break up the splits.
Yeah, that's pretty much. You know, I felt like I was all over the head pin, but I just couldn't get any breaks that last game.
Kristy, you were rolling a great ball. You made it to third place. You had a great finish the second match against Joanne and just had some tough splits coming into this game. I thought you rolled a great ball the whole match.
Thank you.
So hopefully we'll see you back next time. You definitely
I'll be back.
Absolutely. That's what we like to hear.
Good, good. Yeah, you traveled pretty far up our ladder today, so congratulations to you.
Thank you.
For our entire crew and our cast here and our bowlers, we thank you for watching, and we look forward to seeing you next time on Classic Candlepins.